Hey guys, what's up? Well, allow me to do a quick impression of the early iPad naysayers. Oh, it doesn't have a stylus? This sucks. Oh, it really needs a physical keyboard. Oh, no one's gonna want it without any kind of expansion slots. Well, did you guys know Apple did make a portable device with a stylus, a touchscreen, a physical keyboard, options for expansion, and it ran a mobile operating system, and that they made it over 10 years ago? Well, you do now. Let's go ahead, check it out. So guys, here it is, the Apple eMate, which was originally designed to be a cheap computer for classrooms and ran the Newton operating system, which is of course more famous for Apple's PDA line of the mid-90s. As I mentioned, it came with a stylus, like the entire Newton series did, that also included handwriting recognition. Looking at the keyboard at the bottom, it's a standard Apple setup, and at the top it includes special Newton shortcuts. So speaking of Newton, let's take a look at the operating system. So for the eMate, Apple included a pared-down version from the PDAs and included apps that it felt would be good for students, like a basic word processor and calculator. The word processor is in fact the default program it opens up to. Now it also includes a basic paint program. You see the stylus works pretty well, but you're not required to use the stylus. You can see here I'm using it just as a touchscreen. My favorite part of the Newton OS? Well, it's the little touches. The animations and sounds, which really show a cool attention to detail from Apple. As I mentioned in the beginning, it also included external connections, as well as an expansion card slot that some people nowadays will put a wireless card in to bring their eMate online. Another cool feature is the ability to rotate the screen, and because of the outward design, you can actually lay the screen completely horizontal, so I can see the idea behind this being students could hold it almost like a book as they're taking notes. Now many people point to the iOS as the legacy of the Newton, but I think in the case of the eMate, it has much more to do with its outward design. If you look, the clamshell style enclosure is nearly identical to the iBook that was produced a few years later. Also, this was the first Apple product to use translucent plastic, which of course became very popular with the iMac. The entire Newton series was maybe just a little too far ahead of its time. And the eMate, with the rest, were all canceled shortly after Steve Jobs returned to Apple. Well, that's all for this one, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.